Hello students, welcome to my class. Today I am going to take your math subject. In that we are going to see lesson number 1. The name of the lesson is division. Okay students, now before starting to our lesson, they have given little warm up. See students, what they have written here: sharing is caring. Yes, we all love to share, right? And we should always share whatever things or whatever toys, whatever is with us, we should share. Sharing is caring. There are 6 coloring books. Let us distribute them equally between Fabian and Revati. They are having 6 coloring books. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What they are saying, let us distribute. Distribute means equally they have to give to each other. Equally between Fabian and Revati. She is Fabian and she is Revati. Now they have distributed equally. See, one book given to Fabian and this book given to Revati. This book given to Fabian, this coloring book given to Revati. This coloring book given to Fabian and this coloring book given to Revati. Means 3 books have got with Fabian and Revati now. Now see here, there were a total of dash books. How many books were there? 6, right? Now Fabian has dash books and Revati has dash books. After distributing, how many books are there with them? Fabian has 3 books and Revati also has 3 books, right? Now in this lesson, what we are going to see, division as a repeated subtraction. By subtracting also we can do a division. Relation between multiplication and division. Division using a number strip, dividing a 2-digit number by a 1-digit number. Properties of division and word problems. Now see students here, my way ahead. Revati's mother has got her 15 pebbles from Chennai. She has told Revati to share them with 5 of her friends equally. Now what Revati's mother has got? Revati's mother had got 15 pebbles. Pebbles means some kind of stones. There are little stones. You can see here the picture. From Chennai. She has told Revati to share them with 5 of her friends. Her mother is saying you have to share among your 5 friends and that also equally. Now Revati has made 5 circles on the ground. See, you can see here grounds. Sorry. You can see here she had made a circles, 5 circles. Why? Because she want to give to her 5 friends. Yes. Now she placed 1 pebble in each circle. She has placed 1 pebble in each. See, in the circle you can see one pebble. Here one, one, one and one. Now what she has done, then she placed 1 more pebble in each circle. Now she has placed 1 more in each circle. Now she was still left with some more pebbles. After distributing like this, still she has some more pebbles. So she placed 1 more pebble with each circle. Now what she has done, she has placed 1 more pebbles in each circle. See, you can see now here 3 pebbles are there, right? Now there are no pebbles left with Revati. Now all the pebbles are she has put here. And each of her friends get 3 pebbles. Each friend, see, she is will think this, they are the friends, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 friends. And each friend is getting 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Means 3 pebbles each friend will get. Thus she shared the pebbles equally with her friends. Equally means all are getting 3, right? Sharing equally means division. Remember students, when we share whatever in equal, that is called division. And the symbol of division is like this: sleeping line and 2 dots. This is called symbol of the division. A division pact can be made through the following questions. Now, how many pebbles are there altogether? How many pebbles are there? 15, right? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15 pebbles are there, right? How many groups are there altogether? How many groups are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many pebbles are there in each group? In each group means in each group, how many are there? It means in one group there are 3. So, 3. So, the division fact can be written as 15 divided by 5 is equal to 3. If we divide 15 in 5 students or 5 friends, we get the answer 3. Thus, 15 divided into 5 groups will give 3 in each group. Now, say students, we are going to see division as repeated subtraction. How we can do in subtraction form also? See, division can also be shown as a repeated subtraction. Repeated subtraction is how many times a number is subtracted from a given number to get 0. We have to divide the same number till we get the 0. Now see, I remember division is repeated subtraction while multiplication is repeated addition. In multiplication lesson we have learned repeated addition. Yes. Okay students, now we are going to see example they have given. Divide 12 strawberries equally amongst 3 turtles. They have given us 12 strawberries and we have to divide among these 3 turtles. Now see students, you can see 3 strawberries eaten up. They are eating 3 strawberries. Means from 12 they had taken 3. So we are going to cut this. Okay. Now suppose this 3 has gone. They had eaten up. Now again they had eaten again 3. See, you can see the first one. Say again they have started eating. So again we are going to cross this. Okay. Now 6 strawberries eaten. Now till now 6 has eaten up. Now again they had started eating 3. Right. So again we are going to cross. Now 9 strawberries eaten up. Now they had eaten 9 strawberries. You can see, you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now again they had started eating 3. 1, 2, 3. Now see here students, 12 strawberries eaten up. Means all the strawberries they had eaten up. Right. Now there is no strawberries remain. So you can see here from above we get, see here, 12 minus 3. First was there 12 strawberries minus 3. 12 minus 3, 9. Again they took 9 here. 9 minus 3, 6. They took 6 here. 6 minus 3, 3. 3 minus 3, 0. Okay. Means same number you have to subtract from the answer. Okay. Here we have subtracted 3, 4 times. How many times? 4 times. You see, you can count 1, 2, 3, 4. So 12 divided by 3 is equal to 4. This is also known as a division sentence. This is also known as a division sentence. Now students, see they have given you my practice time 1. Solve the following. See they have given some balls. See, you can see how many groups are there. 1, 2, 3. Right? 3 groups are there. And in each group, how many balls are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Means each group there are 5 balls. Okay. Now first question we will see. How many balls are there altogether? Altogether means we have to add. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So how many are there? 15. 15 balls. Okay. Now, how many groups are there altogether? How many groups are there? There are 3 groups. 1, 2, 3. So I am going to write here 3. Now, how many balls are there in each group? In each group? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 balls are there. Okay. Now, so dash divided into dash groups. Dash divided means 15. 15 divided into 3 groups will give 5 balls in each group. Yes, 15 divided by 3 will give 5 in each group. Thus 15 divided by 3 is equal to 5. This is a division sentence, right? This way you have to solve it, this question also. Now say students, number 2, draw boxes to make groups and write a division sentence for each. Now what we have to do? We have to make a groups. Now see, here they have written group of 5. So 5 balls we have to put in a group. Now suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so I will make a box here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I will make a box here. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, I'll make a box. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, students. So, what will be the division sentence? The division sentence will be, See, first you count the total. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Or in a simple way, if you know the table of 5, you can count like that only. 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, 5 fours are 20, right? So I am going to write here 20 division sign, okay? Division sign we have to put. And how many groups are there? How many groups are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And in each group, how many balls are there? 5. So 20 divided by 5 is equal to 4. If see here, 20 is divided in 4 groups. Yes. And in each group, how many balls are there? 5 balls. Right. Now, see one more I will solve for you. Groups of 3. Now we'll make a group of 3. 1 group, 2 group, 3 and 4 groups. Okay. So first we'll count how many candles are there altogether. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay. Then how many groups are there altogether? 1, 2, 3, 4. How many groups are there? 4 groups. And in each group, how many candles are there? There are 3 candles. So 12 divided by 3. 12 divided by 3 means 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, 12 divided by 3 means 4. Okay, answer is 4. Okay, students, rest of the questions we are going to solve like that only. Now, here what we have to do by using repeated addition. Now, here we have to use a repeated addition like this. Like this we have to solve here. Okay. Okay, students, now see, first one they have given 14 divided by 2. Okay, so what we are going to do, first we will write 14, instead of division we are going to write minus sign and 2. So 14 minus 2 is 12, correct? Now 12, we will take this answer here, 12 minus again we will minus 2, 12 minus 2 is 10, correct? Now this 10 we will take here and we will minus 2 from 10, we will get answer 8. Again, this 8 I am going to take here. Again, I will minus 2. See, this number only we have to subtract from the answer. Okay. Like this is the answer. We have to subtract 2 from here. Again, we got 10. Then again, we are going to subtract 2. So, 8. So, what will be the answer here? 6. Then, 6 minus 2. 4. 4 minus 2 is 2 and 2 minus 2 is 0. Okay, students. Now, one more example we are going to see. Suppose this is 12 minus 6, right? So, I will write here. Okay, sorry. 12 divided by 6. So, what we are going to do? We are going to write 12 minus 6 is equal to 6. And we will take this 6 here. Again, this 6 down. And 6 minus 6 is 0. We have to subtract the number till we get answer 0. Okay, students, I hope you all have understood. Rest of the questions you are going to solve similarly. Now, see students, relation between multiplication and division. Now, we are going to see relation between multiplication and division. We can get a division fact out of every multiplication fact. Look at this picture. Now see here, row 1 means this is row 1 and this is row 2. See, they have written here. Means in one row, this is first row, this is second row. There are 12 circles inside the box. You can count and see is there, it is 12 or not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Correct? Now, if you look at the picture, there are 2 rows. Yes, 1 row and 2 row of 6 circles each. That is 2 into 6. That is means 2 rows and how many circles are there? 6. So 2 times 6. 2 times 6. 2 times 6 is equal to 12. Again, there are 12 circles in all. See, again there are 12 circles in all. Since there are 2 rows with 6 circles in each row. What they are saying, since there are 2 rows with 6 circles in each row, means in this row 6 are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So each row has 12 divided by 2 is equal to 6 circles. 12 divided by 2 is equal to 6 circles. See, when you had said that 2 times 6 is 12, yes, when we divide 12 by 2 rows, we get 6. Yes. Now, if you look at the picture, there are 6 columns. Now, see here, there are 6 columns of 2 circles each. Now, you can see these lines. Yes. These are columns, and in each column, 2 circles. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Right. That is 6 times 2. Means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 times 2. 6 times 2 is 12. The answer is 12. You can count and see also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay. There are 12 circles in 6 columns. Now in the 6th column also there are how many circles? 12. So there are 12 divided by 6. Why? Because 6 rows are there. And here we have divided by 2. Why? Because 2 rows are there. Now, so with the same number of objects, we can write 2 multiplication facts and 2 division facts. Like this, see. Here also 12 circles were there. Here also 12 circles are there. Right? Division means the division sentence and the multiplication. 2 times 6 is 12. Yes? And 6 times 2 is also 12. 12 divided by 2 is 6 circles, and 12 divided by 6 is 2 circles. Yes, in both the way, 2 multiplication and 2 division facts we can write. Now see here, my practice time 2. Write 2 multiplication facts and 2 division facts for the following. Now suppose we will say, suppose this is, these are 3 rows, 1 row, 2 row and 3 row. Okay students, now in multiplication how we are going to write 3 into, see 3 rows are there, so I have written here 3, and in each row how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 3, 6 are 18, right? This is the multiplication fact. And again one more multiplication fact we can write, how we can write, see. If I'll make like this, right? If I'll make like this, so 6 rows are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 into, in each row, how many are there? 1, 2, 3. 6 threes are 18, right? And how we are going to write the multiplication? Now, if you divide 18, see, you can count and see, these are 18 circles, 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. 18 divided by 3 rows, 1, 2, 3. 18 divided by 3 is 6. Or you can write 18 divided by 6 is equal to 3. Means 6 rows. Here I have taken 3 rows, 1, 2, 3. And here I have taken 6 rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes? One more I will solve for you people. See students, here suppose I will make again here 3 rows. 1, 1, 2 and 3 rows. Okay. Now I will write here what? I will write here 3 into, in each row how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4. So 3 fours are 12. Right. And suppose I will, here I will divide 1, 2, 3, 4. This way also. Then you can write 4 into 3. 4 threes are also 12. Okay. So, we can write division sentence like this. 12 divided by 4 is equal to 3, or 12 divided by 3 is equal to 4. Like this. If we divide 12 with 3, we get 4. If we divide 12 with 4, we get answer 3. These are the 2 multiplication facts and 2 division facts. These two you are going to solve. Now write the multiplication and division facts using the following numbers. Now we have to use these numbers only to write multiplication and division fact. Yes students, now see here, Write the multiplication and division facts using the following number. First one is 9, 18, 2. Okay, first one is 9, 18, 2. So, I'll write here. First one is 9, 18 and 2. We have to write a division and a multiplication fact. You can see here, multiplication and the division facts of the following numbers. So, what will be the division fact of 9, 18 and 2? See, 9 into 2. 9 times 2 means 18. 9 times 2 means 18. We got 18, right? And how we are going to write in division? 18 divided by 9 is equal to 2. 18 divided by 9, we got the answer 2. And we can, one more multiplication fact we can do. 2 times 9 is equal to 18. Yes, 2 times 9 is equal to 18. And 18 divided by 2 is equal to 9. Means 2 multiplication facts and 2 division facts, right? 9 times 2 is 18. 2 times 9 is also 18. 18 divided by 9 is 2 and 18 divided by 2 is 9. Okay. One more example we'll solve. Second one is 7, 21 and 3. 7, 21 and 3. Okay. For this also we have to take out multiplication and division fact. Now suppose I have written here. First we'll see 7 times 3. 7 times 3 is 21, yes, 7 times 3 is 21, right? And division fact we are going to write 21 divided by 7. See, table of 7, when you will say the table of 7, 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, 7 threes are 21, right? 7 threes are 21. You get the answer 21, yes. So, 21 divided by 7, the answer is 3. And one more multiplication fact we can write, 3 into 7, 3 times 7 is equal to 21. And 21 divided by 3, you will get the answer 7. You will get the answer 7. Okay? Okay, students, I hope you all have understood these division facts. Now, division using a number strip. How we can divide using a number strip. Let us divide 18 by 3 using a number strip. Now they are saying let us divide 18 by 3 using a number strip. 3 means we have to see the table of 3. To do this, start from 0 and take as many steps as of 3 as possible till we reach 18. See, they have said we have to start from 0. And how many steps we have to take? 3. From 0, 1, 2, 3. Means it first step is on 3. Again 1, 2, 3 means 6. 1, 2, 3 means 9. 1, 2, 3 means 12. 1, 2, 3 means 15. 1, 2, 3 means 18. They only said we have to reach till 18. So, here we have taken how many steps? Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 steps to reach 18. So, 18 divided by 3 is 6. How many steps we have taken? 6 steps, right?